After 5 years of experience, I can say that a huge chunk of homebuyers are actually starting their home search entirely backwards. I want you to think to yourself for a moment, what is the first true step in buying a home? Perhaps you answered something along the lines of view homes, go to open houses, call the listing agent and see the listing directly, view homes online. All wrong. The truth is, all of these are entirely wrong. Or more so, they're not entirely correct or just not the right place to start. The first true step in buying a home is a mortgage pre-approval. Now, before you roll your eyes at me too much, I will acknowledge that I see a lot of other agents out there, a lot of mortgage brokers talking about this exact point, to a point that the horse really has been beaten to death and it's a bit of a cliche. So I hope you resisted the urge to close this video so far, because I want to show you why this first step and why getting pre-approved for a mortgage is actually important to you. Now, some of you may have heard me say the first true step in buying a home is getting a mortgage pre-approval. And there's a good chance you thought to yourself, I don't need to get pre-approved. If you thought that, stop. This video is for you, and I'm about to tell you why. The first and main reason to get pre-approved is there truly is nothing more soul-crushing and heartbreaking than finding a home you love and not getting approved on financing. Unfortunately, I can say I know this from firsthand experience because I have seen it happen to people before. It can be a very discouraging experience to find a place you love and then get the rug yanked out from under you because we didn't do the simple due diligence of just checking your finances beforehand. It's actually a pretty quick process. Now, aside from that major benefit to you on more of the emotional level, there's a few practical reasons as well. Ultimately, it will actually reduce your stress of buying a home, and it actually increases your chances of getting the home you want. Now, the practical, pragmatic reason number one is it actually strengthens your offer. With recent mortgage changes over the last few years and a lot of confusion about the new rules today, I'd actually say that the number of pending deals I see not go through because of financing has actually marginally increased over the last 2-3 years. So without getting into the nuances of the new pre-approval rules, those are more questions for your mortgage broker. When we're able to present an offer with a fully complete pre-approval, you actually increase your odds of the seller accepting that offer or being more willing to work with you. Ultimately, it strengthens your offer in a few different ways. And even in this market, the well-priced and very attractive homes sometimes go to multiple offers. So if we have a very strong pre-approval to fall back on, that actually increases your odds of getting the home you want. Practical reason number two is it actually helps you tighten your focus. Look, there's no shortage of listings in this market. I don't think that's a secret. Edmonton's still a buyer's market, and there's still a lot of inventory out there. Without a refined search, the right home could pass you by, right? And potentially if you're looking at homes such as condos or townhomes that may have condo fees that come into the picture, etc., or if you're shopping in slightly different communities where the property taxes or HOA fees differ, we want to know your exact pre-approval so we can make sure we're focusing on finding the right properties. We also know with 100% confidence what you can afford, and that provides you a lot of peace of mind as a buyer, so you're not stressed out going into the home wondering if you can afford it, and you're more focused on finding the right one for you. In fact, most people spend a little bit under what their maximum budget is, which is actually a very good idea for you as a buyer, and I would encourage it. And then we know we have a little wiggle room on your budget if that home you love is maybe just slightly above where you want to be on your price point. Essentially, we don't want to be sweating writing an offer. We should be presenting that offer confidently with your full pre-approval. There's a Ryan Serhant line out there that shopping without a pre-approval is like going shopping without checking your bank account. I couldn't agree more, because generally speaking, when you go shopping at any kind of store, whatever item it is for, you generally know how much money is in your bank account and you also have a vague budget for yourself. But for some reason, some people throw this out the window when they're looking at homes. Now, that's about all I'm allowed to say as a realtor about mortgages. If you have more technical questions, ultimately, you'll need to speak to your friendly neighborhood mortgage broker. I have a great network of brokers and mortgage advisors I can set you up with who are close to you or will often come to you to meet with you and help you out with your pre-approval process. Like I said, it's actually a very simple process and it doesn't really impact your credit at all. You can ask them more for the specifics of that, but there's a lot of misconceptions out there about it. So that's it for today, and those are a few reasons why a mortgage pre-approval is the first true step in buying a home. If you have any questions about the real estate process, just drop me a line below, or you can reach me at hello@thomasharrington.ca, or look up thomasharrington.ca. You can find me pretty much anywhere with that handle. As a disclaimer, I'll just mention that this information is given from my point of view as a realtor and a real estate associate. I can only give general advice when it comes to mortgages and why a pre-approval is perhaps important to you, but I can't give any further technical advice. You will need to speak to a licensed mortgage associate or a qualified mortgage advisor for that. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.